the NYI convention. Your name must be on the paper that is there on the table in the back. You can get up and sign your name. If your name is not signed on that paper, you are not a delegate. You're not an official delegate. So make sure that you are signed in on this piece of paper so we know what church you're from, and we can follow up if there's any discrepancies in voting or anything like that, which we don't anticipate. But at least we're covering ourselves, and we'll know who is official. And I'd like to get things started today and go ahead and get moving. It shouldn't take long. We have really one ballot, and so we're just going to move through it pretty quick. But to start today, I've asked the pastor here at Mustang, Terry Armstrong, to come and greet you and give us a few words before we get started.
It's so good to have you guys here. I love NYI. I believe it is not just only the future of the church, it is the church. And I love the fact that our church believes so much in young people, that we have an organization that helps develop you as not only as Christians, but also as young leaders. We're thrilled to have you here in Mustang. I believe you're going to have a great time tonight in the midst of voting, but also sharing together around the table maybe or something like that. But we're thrilled to have Blair and all of you here, and I'd like to open with just a word of prayer. Let's pray. Father, tonight we take this moment to say thank you for the gift of this day, the gift of life. We think that as we have listened to news throughout last night and early this morning, how brief this life could be and how significant and important it is that our heart is right with you. Lord, I thank you for these young people, and I pray that tonight as they participate in the business of the church, that you would give them a sense of excitement to be part of an organization that loves you and wants to help us grow up in our faith and discover all that it means to be a part of your body. May you bless us, and Father, most of all, may we be a blessing to you in Christ's holy name. Amen.
I believe our district superintendent is here, back there. He waved his hands at us. And Dr. Cooper, I want you to be prepared to pray at the end, if you would, and dismiss us if you can. I would like to give you just a quick NYI President's Report for this year and read that from what I've typed. It's been a privilege for me to serve as the District NYI President. We've had a good year and connected in so many ways. It's been another, I think it's been a just great time of our district youth growing closer together and closer to Christ. And I've seen that in so many different ways this year. But I want to just highlight some of the events, and then I'll just finish by reading the rest of the report. First thing is Extravaganza. Extravaganza is an event that, how many of you went to Extravaganza this year? It's not highly attended, to be honest, from our district. I'd love to change that. But we were well represented. There's a group of girls that come up from Altus, and they come up every year, and they play in the basketball tournament at Extravaganza. They won the whole thing this year. That's pretty neat. And that was fun to watch them. We had a GPS geocaching team that does this big scavenger hunt across the campus, and we've won that the last 2 years, and it's been fun. But there's been a lot of people who've come and shared their talents, who've sung or played an instrument, been involved in quizzing, and we've had some really good chances just to be together. The worship this year was just outstanding. If any of you went, it was Bailey, and they were just so good. And Ron Jackson, who spoke at our camp, was also the speaker at Extravaganza. And just amazing time with the whole region, and it was just really neat. We had one of our students, Sarah Jackson, make it into what they called the show. And the show is a big talent show at the end of Extravaganza. From all the regions, there's 10 or so people that they pick to be in this all-star show, and they do it upright, and it's really neat. And she actually was doing this dance, and it was beautiful, and she did a great job with it. We went to Frontier City this year at Extravaganza, and that was fun. It was unique. It was new, but it was well attended, and we had several bands there and had a great time. We are planning to do that again this year. So if you would like to go to Extravaganza, you can get signed up. You need to do that on your own. Youth leaders, you need to push the way. It's SNUExtravaganza.com, SNUExtravaganza.com, and you can get registered there. And we are planning to go to Frontier City as a region again, and it will be exciting, and I'm looking forward to that. NYC 2011. Wow. How many people went to NYC 2011? Very formative event. It was spectacular in so many ways. From beginning to end, it was just God-filled, and it was outstanding. I saw God move in real ways in the lives of our students. From my church, from the district, we had a lot of conversations about where they are with the Lord, and it was just one of those. Yeah, it's an event, but it was a great moment to be together. Lance Redinger, where's Lance? Is he back in there? There he is. He was our NYC coordinator, and I gotta say it was so well done, and the experience could not have been better. And I want to just highlight some of the things about NYC 2011 to Louisville. First of all, we drove all day July the 4th. So we gave up that holiday, spent all day on the timeline buses, which at first everybody admits they were outstanding. I mean, these buses had, you know, wireless. They were outstanding. We had our own, you know, plugs and everything. I mean, they were neat. And we were driving and had a great time. We got all the way to Louisville and went right into our hotel and then went out and got on a riverboat called the Spirit of Louisville. And we were on the riverboat with two other districts. One was Dallas District, and the other was the Louisiana District, which DeBoit was the NYI president in Louisiana, who's now, she found the Lord, and she moved to Oklahoma. So it's good to have her there. But we had a blast on this boat. I mean, we just ate and sat around and laughed. And then, I don't know, that's all teens need to do, just eat and sit around. It doesn't matter where you're at. I mean, just eat and hang out. And you see all kinds of things start happening, like planking and owling and all sorts of things. We weren't T-bowing at that time, thank goodness. But we watched the fireworks from the riverboat, and it was so cool. A good way to start out the whole event. Then we got to the hotel. The hotel, we happened to land at the Galt House, which is this beautiful old historic hotel, and it's so nice. And we were on the third floor of this hotel, and everybody there just knows that it was the prime location. I mean, it was fantastic. We didn't have to get on the elevators that were always crowded. We could go down the escalators. We could go across the skywalks to the auditorium. We'd go to the skywalks to the convention center. Perfect. So I don't know how Lance figured that out and worked it out, but it was outstanding. The ministry to others was the first thing that we did, ministry with others. And we divided our district into all these different groups, and we went and ministered. Some of us painted. Some of us did just manual labor. Some of us cleaned. Some of us did these beads for autism in the nice air conditioning. And I know it was strenuous, but yes, tough on the arm. But it was an outstanding just time for us all to give back to the city of Louisville and the people who are in need, which is why one of the reasons why we went. On the same note, we did this thing called Bundles of Hope. Bundles of Hope was where each student and adult got a baby's, like, just diaper bag filled with stuff, brand new stuff. bottles. And the report said that over 8,000 kids are homeless or orphans in Louisville. Over 8,000 kids. The low-income families in Louisville have trouble providing their kids with basic items, diapers and bottles. So NYC, knowing they saw the need, they donated over 35,000 of these items to the city of Louisville. They filled over six semi-trucks filled with these materials that were in such a need in that city. And so that was an amazing thing when you come together as a church, what you can do. It's outstanding. The SNU VIP party, that was the first event of NYC, was just one amazing Nazagroove party, if you know what I'm talking about. It was outstanding. The other regions were trying desperately to get into our opening event. It was that crazy, and there was so much fun going on. And obviously, NYC over the years has changed. this was quite an event, but it was really, really fun and another good way to start this whole thing up. Our services, everyone can give you their own experience. They were true experiences with God. The speakers were amazing. The theme was A World Unbroken, and we were drawn into this wonderful story of God. From creation to restoration, we were asked to be part of this incredible, amazing story for all of us to enter into it and to understand that, yes, we've been broken and there's brokenness in our world. But because of the covenant made with Abraham, because of the incarnation in Jesus Christ, because of the infilling of the Holy Spirit, we can work then as the church to bring restoration to a broken world. And that is a great message. Because of Jesus and his sacrifice, we can bring peace and wholeness to people. And that's what it was all about. Some of the favorites were Francis Chan. And he just connected so well. And Reggie Dabbs and Starfield led in worship, and they were amazing and authentic, and they just know how to lead worship. And just lives were changed and challenged in these services. Everybody there knows what I'm talking about. And some of the concerts were fun too, especially Toby Mac. David Crowder got a little out of hand. We had people getting hurt in that one, but... It was a fun time together. The Yum Center where we met was neat. It was just beautiful, and it was a great setting. And there were so many things that went into this, seminars and all just the time walking and the meals we shared and just the fun that we had. The exhibit hall, the schools and their influences. Kings Island we went to after we were done. It was great fun. And, of course, I've always already said it, the most important part of all that investment was that students were challenged to be leaders and to be part of this grand story of Christ and his redemption in the world. And that led right into Camp 2011. It wasn't but a week later that we ended up at Camp Bond again together. And if you went to NYC, you got camp free. So there was a good group. We had about 270 at Camp Bond. Remedy was an awesome group from SNU, and they led worship. Ron Jackson was our speaker, as I've already mentioned. And I'm just always amazed at camp to see how responsive our students are. And just the openness and just the feeling that, listen, we're here, and this is our family, and we're worshiping together. I really wish some of you who haven't been part of it, students or adults, could just come to some of the services at Camp Bond in the evening and just see those altars just lined with students seeking the Lord, really dealing with issues, really submitting and consecrating their lives. That is what sustains me in youth ministry. Events like that. I get weary of programs. I get weary of planning. I get weary of lock-ins. I get weary of staying in tents. I get weary of sleeping on the floor. I get weary of inflatable mattresses and how they never stay inflated. I get weary of small groups, all of these things. But I never get weary of seeing a life that has been challenged and changed by Jesus Christ. And I see that so distinctly with students in those kind of settings and on everyday basis and every week. And so it's been exciting to be part of this district and be part of the youth. And I'm excited for another great week of camp this year as Remedy is coming back. They're a new group this year, but they will be there, and it's going to be outstanding. And I hope that you can get registered. You can go to our website, SWOKNYI.org, and get the registration forms there, and you can just download them. After camp and after NYC, I felt like, especially for those who had been in attendance, but even the overflow of their excitement going back to their youth ministry, I felt like our district had drawn closer together, both adults and students. I felt like a lot of some of the barriers that had been there kind of were down. I mean, we all just saw each other as a family in many ways. And so I was in October and I was thinking, man, I miss being with the district. I miss hanging out with them, you know. Oh, I don't want to have to wait till camp next year or extravaganza. And so I was sitting in my office and I thought, now how can we try to reproduce the camp service? How can we connect again? And so I decided we'd do this thing called GLOW, and I talked with the district council, and they were all, hey, yeah, let's do this. And so the first one we did, called GLOW, we met at Trinity in October, and we had about 200, 250 students show up from all over the district. It was an amazing time just of worship. There wasn't really much there. We just hung out, and then we worshiped the Lord, and it was outstanding. So we did it every other month from that point. So in December, we ended up going to Mustang, right? Mustang in December. And Brett gave a great message here. And then in February, we were at UConn. And then we just, last Wednesday, we were at Western Oaks and had about 175 there at Western Oaks. And another, every one of these services has been outstanding. And I know it's on Wednesday night, so not everybody can come, and we understand that. But everyone's invited. Pastors, you can come on. The next one's in June. We're going to work on trying to get it down in Norman. And it's summer, so we have a lot more freedom. We may go to a park or do something of that like. But we want you to be a part of this. What's happened is it's kept us connected in many ways. We've seen students that we were with all summer. We've seen them all year long and been able to just, not for long, but at least to reconnect. So I'm really anticipating camp this year to be another just outstanding gathering of our district. And it's been great. It's been a great year. At the past GLOW at Western Oaks, Pastor Nick Bollinger spoke about the need to create space and how important that is. We need to create space in our lives for God. He spoke of how he had found solace in the midst of tragedy. You see, Nick and Lori were supposed to go to NYC with us. But just days before we were supposed to leave, the day before, the tragic loss of Sid Emmer and just kind of derailed their plans. And we were all heavy in our hearts. We prayed for them. God really spoke to me last Wednesday night through Nick in his message. We must all remember to carve out time in our lives and be willing to step on holy ground and to get close to Jesus. And we must be watching in all of our busyness and scurrying about. We must be watching for God to show up in our lives, right? We must take time in all of the busyness just to stop and let God speak truth to us. If we will, He will. If we take time for Him, He will meet us there. He'll do it. And so my challenge for us this year is to just follow Nick's example, to make more and more room in the crazy lives that teenagers and their sponsors and adults live, to take the time to carve out space for Christ. I know it's tough. I know you have schedules. I know you have scholarships to keep. I know you have GPAs to keep up. I know you have all kinds of things that are coming your way. But you need to make more and more room in your life for God. May we consecrate ourselves and know that God will do great things among us. And this is my report of the year 2011, 2012. And I'm excited for next year. Okay? Do we have to make a motion to accept that report? Okay, good. So moved and accepted. All right. Now we're going to go into the business of the general the district convention, NYI convention. We have several business items to take care of this year. I will set the bar in. Is everybody in here a delegate, a voting delegate? Those who are on the fringes. If you're a voting delegate, it would probably be best if we could move into the middle or just be aware. I need your name on a piece of paper if you are a voting delegate and it's back in the back. Make sure you sign that up. Even if you're a pastor, I need to make sure that I have your name on that back. We are going to do two orders of business, basically. The first order of business is we're going to vote for president and vice president. And on a yes and no ballot, the president is myself. I just gave that report in case you didn't know. And then Kent Mullins is the vice president. Kent, where are you? Right here. Most of you know Kent from UConn, and he's been the vice president here. And so it's going to be a yes no ballot on that. This has been approved by the nominating committee and the district superintendent. We're also going to vote for our global NYI convention delegates, which meets right before the General Assembly. And so there are several delegates that we will vote for. That we will vote for a pastoral delegate, we will vote for a student delegate, and we will vote for a lay delegate to go to General Assembly. Those that get elected will then be sent as our representatives to the global convention in Indianapolis next summer. So it's a pretty important vote. It's important for us to realize these people will go as our representatives. And the nominating committee has already gathered the ballot, and there are names already on the ballot. And so it should happen that we just do one scantron where we fill out the names to the ballot. And we'll explain all that. We'll have the names up on the screen, and then you can fill them out, and we'll pass these up. I do need about four people, if they would, come up here at this point. Just four students real quick, jump up and help me pass out these ballots. Okay, and just get ready, and I'll give you instruction here in just a little bit. Before we do start the vote, I would like to have a motion made that would accept those who are second and third in the voting. We would accept them as alternates to the global convention. So the person who wins the vote will be the delegate, and the other two would be the alternates, and we would just send in case something happens and that person cannot attend. We need alternate delegates, okay? But we so moved. Is there a second? All in favor say aye. All opposed, same sign. Okay. I think it passed. So that's what we'll do. And now we're going to ask anyone who is a delegate who has put their name on the piece of paper, who is a pastor, an NYI president, or an official delegate from your church who has a vote in this convention to please stand. And we're going to pass out pencils and ballots to you. And then I'm going to explain before. Do not mark on this when you get it. Just get your pencil and get your ballot. And I'll explain to you all that needs to be explained about the ballot on screen. When you get your ballot and your pencil, please take a seat. Both of these votes today will be by majority vote. A majority vote means you have to get a majority. That is different from a plurality. A plurality vote would be whoever gets the most votes, if there's more than two, whoever gets the most votes wins the election. That is not what we're going to do today. The manual spells it out that we must get a majority vote for the delegate. And so if there's not a full majority, which we'll figure that out from your ballot, then we'll have to vote again, dropping off to whether. What we'll do is we'll drop off the last names and vote for two, unless there's a real close between three. Okay, and we'll make that decision as we go. All right, everyone has a pencil. Everyone has a ballot. All right, now we're going to put up on the screen the ballot. And I want to explain, I want to kind of go through the whole idea. So I see it in the back. It's not in the front. It's coming, though. Okay, so you look at your Scantron, and you'll see number one or number two. You will clearly mark, you've done this at school, you know, your ACT. You make little patterns on it. You will clearly mark with your number two pencil the one that you think is best. Don't do it yet. Please don't vote yet. Okay, go to the next slide. President, vice president, 2 years, yes or no. And you'll see it. Go to the next slide. All right. Here's our pastoral delegate. You can vote for one. You can vote for one of these. Brett Armstrong. Brett, will you stand real quick so everyone knows who you are? That's Brett. Nick Bollinger had to be dealing with the loss of a dad of one of his students, so he couldn't be here today. Kent Mullins is right here. From UConn, and Craig Shepard from Norman. It's right here. All right, so you will vote for one of these. Make sure you mark it clearly. Don't vote yet, but get ready. I'll let you in just a second. NYI Global Convention lay delegates. Melissa Garrett from UConn, are you here? There's Melissa, long time Southwest Oklahoma. Jason Lemke from Mustang, not present. Lance Redinger from Trinity, back in the back. He didn't stand, but he waited. Nate Stevenson from Norman. So don't vote yet, but you will vote 16 through 18 through 19. You will mark the one that you want. The next slide. We have five students that have been nominated. Shelby Martinez from Canadian Hill. Is she here? She is not here. I haven't seen her. Cooper Milford from Trinity. It's right there. Brianna Mullins from UConn is not here. She's at a choir concert. Alex Scott from Norman is right there. And Caitlin Shoemaker from Altus couldn't be here, but she's an awesome girl. So those are the names. You will vote when it comes time. You will fill it in completely. And you can vote. Let's go back to screen one. Okay, does everybody understand? Are there any questions before we vote? Do you have any questions, anything on your mind? I take that as no questions. Okay, so let us vote now. Go ahead and fill in your ballots completely, and we'll scroll through these screens as we go. You can go ahead and go to the next screen. Next screen. Okay, let's go through this one more time just so you can double check to make sure you've marked the right one. If you're done with your vote, let's just stand up and we will collect those same tellers, please come forward. Brett, if you and Brent. When you've given your ballot, or just you can pass them all the way over. That might be easier. Now, it may be that we have to have another vote. If we don't reach a majority on the first ballot, we will have to re-vote, and that's okay. Right now, I'd like to show, as we wait for the votes to be counted, I'd like to show just a little bit of the NYC highlight video for some of those of you who didn't experience it. Maybe this will give you a little teaser about what's coming up in 3 years now, almost, NYC, and get you excited about telling other people about getting involved. I know some people are already making their plans to go to NYC. I kind of already know where it is because I was in the inside NYI meeting, but I'm not telling you. So, unless you pay me. No, I'm just joking. Let's watch this video just for a little bit until as the ballots are being run, and then we'll see what the results are, and if we need to take another vote, we'll go from there.
dash along the street for a few miles. And it just felt great because we gave back to the community that let us host this great event, and we just appreciate all they're doing for us, so we just did that back to them.
Taking a village and just going out and working. I mean, I think it's kind of cool to be able to say that we brought a city here to fix things.
There and just pitch in stuff and see how much stuff there was there. Like, this is going to help somebody.
Thank you. One big old happy room of Nazareniacs. We are made for more. We are yours. We are yours. You are all our hearts are beating for. And you will always be. We don't want what the world gives anymore. For you are all we need.
Say, Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, have mercy on me, a sinner. Let me tell you something. The gospel that God has called us to does not manage brokenness. The gospel that God has called us to just unbreaks it. You are God and we are not. And because of that, we're giving our lives to this mission, your mission. We will participate with you to restore this world to its intended wholeness. That's what we're here to do. So I don't know why you came here. I don't judge that. I'm not trying to lay guilt on you if you've come here for some other reason. I'm just trying to say that this week, God, if you let him, will rip your face off. And he'll give you a new vision. He'll change your life in a way that you go back to your community and you can't not be the same fountain of sending love that he's been for us, that got us here in the first place.
Rising up to take the place with selfless faith, selfless faith.
Try to go it alone, I get shut down, locked up and held captive in the clutches of my doubt. We go back, we go forth, we go back, sick with vertigo, weary of my ways, my days, my hands are closed.
All right, we're going to slow this. We're going to pause this for a second. We have some results back, and they're going to reconfigure those in the computer, and we have to take one more vote, which shouldn't take long. But while we're waiting, Abby Odell came and talked to me. She has something she's going to do this summer, and she's just dying to tell you all about it. So will you come in here and just explain to us where you were going and what you were doing this summer? Abby's from UConn Church of Nazarene, and so she was prepared to do this. We talked about this at GLOW, so she's going to share with you what she has going this summer.
I was somewhat prepared. Okay, so this summer I am going to Kenya, Africa, Nairobi. I'm going to be staying at Africa Nazarene University. I'm going with a group called Mission Immersion. They take students over every year, but this year is special, kind of. They're taking only 100 students from the United States and Canada, all juniors or seniors in high school, with the same sense of calling that I've had in my life, a calling into missions. So I'm going on this trip to try to figure out if God wants me in foreign missions. We're going to be taking classes, kind of, not standard classes, but they're going to be teaching us like how to be missionaries, and it's really exciting. We're not really sure what we're doing over there yet. They just told us to come prepared for anything. We get to go on safaris and stuff and go into the culture. And we're going to be doing service projects, but they have no idea what those are yet. So I'm nervous because I don't know what I'm doing, but it's going to be really exciting. I had to raise $3,500, and I have reached that goal last last Friday night, my friend Zachary Sutton had a concert for me, and I ended up raising the money that I didn't have raised. So now I'm all set to go, but I'm still trying to raise money, because if I raise more than what my $3,500, I get to sponsor a child from Africa to also attend the program, which is really special because they don't live in places where they can raise money. So that's what I'm reaching for now. So.
Thank you, Abby. I just thought it would be good for us as a district to commit to her to pray. She has the money. And maybe, you know, if you feel led to try to help sponsor a child in Africa, then maybe you could talk to her about donating some money to that. It's for a very good cause. How many of you have spent time in a work and witness project like that? Raise your hand. Several of you. How formative are those moments in your life? Pretty formative. I know a lot of you were affected. I think Craig would still be there if he could. In where were you? In Croatia and Kosovo. And I know that God has called us to those that need a hand, those that need care, those that need love, those we aren't just designed to take care of ourselves, but to take care of others, and to experience the gospel in other cultures and to share it. So, Abby, we're proud of you for that. I hope some others of you might get involved in youth and mission and some things like that. So we're going to give you results right now of the ballots, and then we have two. We have to vote one more time, so I'll have those tellers get ready. All right, so let's go to the first slide. Are we ready? Are we just doing the slide? Okay, so let's do the other vote, and we'll give all the results at the end. How about that? Can we do that? All right, so tellers that help me come back up. If you are a voting member, please stand up, and we'll get you your ballot. We are voting on the lay delegate and the student delegate to Global Convention. The lay delegate and the student delegate to Global Convention. As before mentioned, we eliminated the lowest two vote getters, and so there will be a narrowed down vote getters. We've already decided by motion that the first, the highest vote getter will be the delegate. The next highest vote getter will be the alternate. We've already decided that. So as soon as you get your ballot and you're ready to vote and everybody's seated, we'll put the slides up and we will vote. Okay, the numbers are on the screen. Remember to vote on the right number, and you can vote now. Okay, next slide. Go back to the first slide. Double check your answers here. Okay. Would you stand up if you're done voting? Pass those to your all the way to the end of the aisle. And my tellers, if you would please pick them up. All right. I don't know if is the video still queued. I did not hear. I see it is not still queued. All right. Well, then we're going to kill a little bit of time here. And what I'd like to do is ask our DS to come up. I know I told you, but Dr. Cooper believes in the NYI, and he's been a real supporter of mine. And I just want him to share his vision a little bit. Now, he's going to do this later for a long time. But you
know me too well.
I know you well. But I just want you to share with your NYI your vision for them and your challenges for them.
Thanks. It's I appreciate the opportunity. I'm glad I get to be the killer of time. Okay. So I hope I can kill the time and kill it well. All right. Does that make sense? NYI shaped my life in many ways. Camps at on the district. Those were times where. I encountered God in special ways, and He encountered me, I should say, and reshaped me. Youth in mission radically changed my life. It happened later when I was an adult, but I became involved as a youth pastor with Youth in Mission to the point that I just finally moved overseas to another country and became a missionary, cross-cultural in another country. NYC, yes, I was there as a youth, and then later twice as a sponsor. And those moments in NYI, along with all kinds of district activities and events, God used in special ways in my life. I'm saying that to say this to you. I hope you will go back to your churches and encourage every student you can find to come along with you and be a part. Because you'll be influencing them by helping them be a part of this fellowship and what God does in our midst when we meet together as student ministries NYI on this district. So you're kind of the ambassador now. Obviously, you're here, so you have some interest in it. And so I'm counting on you going, being the ambassadors to go back and tell others about it and get more people involved because it radically can shift your life in new ways. Now, when I used to live in Oklahoma about 20 years ago and 22 years ago, went to Brazil. For a time there, about 4 or 5 years, and then moved out to the West Coast to San Jose, California for 13 years. And when God began to speak to your district advisory board, and they were working together in the call of a district superintendent, and they called me and said, Southwest Oklahoma would like for you to come as district servant. I said, where? Because I never envisioned myself of being a part of Southwest Oklahoma. It just wasn't, I thought, you know, I'd grown up in the Ozarks and Arkansas, and I just thought that my life had gone south, obviously, to South America, and then back to the West Coast. And I just didn't envision myself coming back to this part of the country. But it was a moment on the advisory board. I don't think, I've never said this in public, so you're the first ones to hear it. There was a moment in your district advisory board, I understand, that the people began to talk about, well, Jim gets our culture. He grew up in Northwest Arkansas. He pastored in Oklahoma. He went to Southern Nazarene University, so he understands this. And if I'm not mistaken, Jess Middendorf, the general superintendent, said, well, but Jim sort of changed over the years. You know, he's gone into another culture, and San Jose is a city of 53 languages with no majority. It's a whole different world. And I'm glad he said that. He's a friend of mine, but I'm glad he said that, because it was then that a layperson on your advisory board said, and that's exactly why we want him to come, because we're no longer reaching our communities and penetrating our world, and we need to do something to shift the culture and change. My whole life has been about being committed. I didn't intend for it to, but it's just the way God worked it out, being committed to church renewal. And trying to help people let go of traditions that are no longer fruitful and embrace the new thing that God's doing in our midst. Now, I've noticed something along the way, that God often speaks to the organization, whatever that is, a business or a church, speaks to the organization from the outside, people who are outside the organization informing what's going on inside because they have fresh eyes and new ears. They can see it differently and they hear differently. For the Church of the Nazarene, what I've seen over my lifetime is it's been through the NYI, through student ministries, that God often speaks newness and the new thing He wants to do into the life of the church. And so my hope for you is that you will represent God well in His new thing that He wants to do in Southwest Oklahoma, breaking down traditions that no longer are fruitful. I'm not talking about just throwing over traditions for the sake of change. I'm not about throwing over anything that is fruitful. But if it doesn't count for the mission of Jesus, why in the world are we spending our time and money and energy doing it? To help people let go of that and embrace the new thing that God's doing is so helpful when a young person says it and demonstrates it, because you can get away with murder in your local church because you're a youth and they love you and they value you and they value your voice. And God might use you to speak the newness that your church needs or your district needs because you are young. Embrace the role that God has for you to play in His church. That's my hope and vision for you, because He has some good thing to do through you and with you because you are young. When you get old and bald and what little hair you have left you shave off, then you can do what I do. Okay? Speak the new thing. Join the prophet Isaiah when he said, "Look, God's doing a new thing. Don't you see it? Already it's springing up in your midst." You be the ones to show it, do it, say it out loud, demonstrate it, question why we're doing what's not fruitful, and help the church birth new growth. God bless you. You were so impressive to me in your worship at camp last summer. I've committed to coming to every service this year at youth camp, if not staying the whole time. So see you there. Thanks.
Thank you very much. A couple things I heard in that. One, I didn't hear from him that you are the church of the future. I didn't hear that. And I like that. There was never this, oh, one day you're going to be the church, and one day. No, you are the church now. I mean, you are so important. And I said that at GLOW, and it's on my heart. And don't let anyone tell you any differently. You have a voice. You are the church, and you need to know that. The other thing I heard is, and I love about Dr. Cooper, is that he believes in cross-cultural missions. And I am convinced that is what NYI needs. We need adults to cross-culturally invest in youth, because there are different languages being spoken. There are young people who have been brought up in a digital age where everything's circular and everything is click this and you go here and click. Logic has changed. Thinking has changed. The way we experience things have changed. And one thing is constant in this world that I know, it's changing. That's a constant. I mean, there's so much change and generationally, and so we need adults to take seriously the challenge to be cross-cultural missionaries to reach our youth. And thank you, adults. And I had a prayer for every adult that works with youth Wednesday night. We are so thankful. We are so blessed by you. Pastors, thank you for investing in youth, for investing not only resources, but time and prayer and the other things of the church. Well, we have some results, but we have one more vote. we have all of them decided, but the last, the student delegate vote. And so, and the only way that can happen, that you did not get a majority when you have two people, is there was a complete tie. And so we have to break the tie. I haven't really seen that happen, except it did happen 2 years ago. Okay, so we're going to do this again. We have the slide ready. We need everyone who needs to vote real quickly. We're going to do it in quick motion. Stand up. Okay. Tellers, hurry. You know the drill. Get the pencils out there. Stand up if you're a delegate. Don't drop out on us now. We had two less votes. Two less votes that time. So, someone has to change their vote or we'll be here all night. All right, when you get your ballot, go ahead and be seated and vote. Make sure you fill in the right number. Oh, please don't fill out the extra ballots. All right, when you are done voting, stand up and pass them down the aisle.
Ballots in. Last chance.
Okay. A motion. Well, I want to make a motion, or we need a motion. Dan, will you speak that motion? Okay. Before you second it, let's describe it. What he means is if there's another tie, you go back to the first ballot, and whoever had the most votes on the first ballot, we will elect as delegate. Whoever had the second most, we will elect as alternate. Okay, is there a second? All in favor say aye. All opposed say no way. Thank you for that vote. Do you have that in the minutes? Okay, so that's what we'll do. If there's another tie, we won't have to kill more time. We will just be able to go from the results of the first ballot. Plus, we need to get out of here because after we're done, there's pizza over there. I think it's there. I don't know if it's there yet or not, but it should be pizza. And so it's free for you as soon as we get done here. All right. How many of you have been to one of the glow services? Raise your hand if you've been to one of the glow services. Okay. Been to one. You need to come back. Okay. The service for June, we want you to come, and it's going to be a new event, and we're excited about it. We may take all day long and just kind of make it a fun day. And then end with the service at night. We may do a service project. So I just want you to be marking your calendar for GLOW. The other thing I wanted to challenge you with, and I already mentioned it, but extravaganza. Extravaganza is Memorial Day. We have not had a great number of folks from Southwest Oklahoma attend, and we need I'm just telling you this. You don't have to. I know it's Memorial Day. I know this year, at least for my students and more, they have graduation on Saturday. All of the more schools, and it's tough. It's a tough time. But if you can, if you have the resources, and if you can get there, it is an outstanding event. I mean, it is fun. The worship is truly amazing. The speakers are great. We have One Time Blind coming back, and they are doing, I don't know if you heard One Time Blind. They did NYC, when was that, in Houston? Was it in Houston, 03? One Time Blind, and they were just this awesome drama group. Their drama, and then they kind of just preached through drama. They were actually at Extravaganza about 3 years ago. And they're really outstanding. So it's definitely worth your time. Again, SNUExtravaganza.com. Plus, you just click the little Frontier City ticket, and it costs, I think, $15 extra. And Dre Murray is coming to Frontier City, who kind of does rap, and he has a DJ with him, as well as some other bands that show up. And we kind of make it a Nazarene Christian SNU day at Frontier City, which is kind of fun. It's kind of a good time to go. So we just challenge you to do that. And the other thing that I wanted to say about camp last year that I forgot, it was in my report. It was really neat last year having 15 students and adults from Brazil. I don't know if you remember them, but what happened at camp last year was we had a soccer tournament. And the soccer tournament ended up being like nationalities. It was, they all chose countries. There was the U.S., okay? I think a lot of those kids from Western Oaks and UConn were the U.S. There was the Brazilians, who were pretty good, especially with their footwork. They were amazing. There was the Koreans, and Korea had a great team. There was China, which I think there's only one Chinese guy, and then the rest of them just said, hey, I want to be Chinese. So they were the Chinese team, and was there another team? The Mexico, yeah. Jason's like, Mexico, Adoracion, yeah. And it was fun. Who won? Did we know who won? The U.S.? U.S. won, I think. But they represent... So it was kind of a World Cup of soccer. It was kind of fun. This year, we're working on the theme, but I just want to give you a hint and a heads up that the theme's going to have something to do with the Olympics, okay? And we're going to play some games that I promise you will not be in the Olympics this summer. They will not. They will be fun, but they will definitely not be official. So... we're looking forward to that. You can go to swonyi.org, or you can go to the district website and it links over to it, right? And just make sure on the website right now, I was on it just the other day, and if you click the pictures, which you should be able to click, it doesn't do anything. You just got to go up to the menu up top and click it. And it'll take you there. And then you can download that stuff and send it in to me, and I'll get your registrations, okay? Are there any questions about the things that are coming up? Any thoughts, any testimonies? Anybody have anything to say when we have this opportunity? Yes. Okay, that's a good question. Where are you going? Well, we are too. Trinity is going to Joplin June 10th through the, yep, only we went right through Joplin, actually. We went before they set up the building, we went through them. Are you going the same week? You're going in July. Yeah, we're going to be building, and before, I called the lady at the Joplin office, which, by the way, youth pastors, they're doing a Okay, we got the results in. They're doing a great work there in Joplin to rebuild after the tornado, which is close to our hearts here in Oklahoma, right? So if you want to be involved in a mission trip that's close to home and it's really cheap, I encourage you to check this Joplin. You know, we are not going through Mission Encounter. We're going through Nazarene, NMI. So, but it's all right. Either one, they're both great. They both work. Just go and serve. All right. We have results, and we'll be done with the convention. All right. Here we go. Do we have them on slide? We have an election. Blair Spindle, Kent Mullins, Brett Armstrong, Lance Rediger, and Alex Scott have been elected to the those three have been elected to Global Convention. Thank you so much. Okay, we're done. Pastor Dr. Cooper has already spoken to you. Can I pray a prayer of blessing for you and for the food? And we are dismissed, okay? God, thank you for these students and adults who have taken their time this year to invest. Lord, we pray that you will keep them involved in their churches, that they would become leaders, that they would realize how important they are. Lord, be with the assembly, God, as we do the business of the assembly, as we hear the words, and we just pray that your blessing would be over all that we do. And we'll give you the praise in Christ's name, to bless the food to nourish our bodies. And everybody said, amen. You are dismissed. Thank you so much.